Here are this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. We'll start with RenderNet. They had a little bit of a viral tweet this week.
This morning, I got into the craziest fight with Captain America over his shield.
My cat hacked my computer.
People always ask me, what's the secret to your muscles?
And there's the ability with this new feature to create lip-synced videos with narrator. Let's go in and try it out. So here in RenderNet, we just launched the app, and of course you can log in with your Google account. First, we'll try out the free sample video, which is available without having to pay anything, okay? I'm gonna go on to next, and I can choose a different voice. So we've got tons of different voices here. Let's have a listen to Alice.
Just trust yourself, then you will know how to live.
Okay, she sounds good and confident. We'll use her. We're going to use a sample script, or we can write our own. Only 60 characters in the free plan, so let's just try this. You should subscribe to Creator Magic. It's really cool. And click Generate. Okay, so this was generated in low priority mode as I'm currently on the free plan. Let's play it back.
You should subscribe to Creator Magic. It's really cool.
Okay, you can see that's pretty realistic. There's eye blinking, there's movement there. It looks really, really amazing. Just from a text prompt, I can get something like that. Okay, so I'm feeling pretty good about what I've seen so far. I'm going to upgrade to Pro and try out some of the Pro end features. Okay, now I've got the Pro plan. I'm going to upload a video of mine. Now note, they can be 2560 by 2560 maximum at a rate of 60 FPS, and they must be in MP4 format. With that done, I'll select this and I will go ahead and keep the original character in there. That's what I want to do. I'm going to again write my own script, and I'm going to choose a different voice here. I'll go for maybe Adam.
Our distrust is very expensive.
Regular intro to my video. Let's click generate and see exactly what comes up. And here we have it. Let's listen and watch.
Here are this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss.
Okay, I gotta say, I'm pretty blown away with how bad that was. My face was static and it was like I had a superimposed set of lips moving, kind of like a Monty Python sketch. But maybe I didn't follow best practices there. Let's just test narrator again. And this time, instead of source video, I'm gonna use swap face, and I'll go ahead and I'll drag and drop an image I've taken of myself here and see how this face swapping feature works. So there I am, there's my face. I'm gonna tick and select that. And in this one, I'll choose a completely different voice. Let's listen to Arnold.
There's power in looking silly and not caring that you do.
Okay, that's cool. I'm going to use that and write a quick script there, and we'll click generate, and we'll see what comes up from this result where I'm using the narrator feature to do a face swap on our original female narrator that we had, but with my face superimposed and a completely different voice. Just while this is rendering out, I'll actually show you that you can choose from a bunch of different library voices they have on RenderNet. You can also upload your own audio, so if you've recorded a script or if you use something such as 11 Labs, you could throw in that AI-generated voice and have it sync to your avatar, which is really cool. Something I'd like to see in the future that I can't see yet is the ability to clone your voice as well as your face and have a fully generated avatar of yourself.
If you're enjoying what you see so far, throw a like and remember to subscribe.
So if we look and analyze carefully, yeah, it's definitely the female face with the original hair there. The eyes are slightly different. The nose is different. I don't think it's got those from my face. The beard it has cloned exactly, but that's about it. So if I wanted to put my beard on a female face, this is the AI tool to do it. Now, maybe I'm not using this exactly correctly to get the best results, but you can see how this narrator could work powerfully. I think there will be a lot of tweaks and upgrades required to make this ready for prime time, but it's definitely something to test out, especially for free, RenderNet's new narrator, which you can go and try right now using the links down below. Now let's move on and talk about Runway Gen 3 Alpha. I've covered it before in my AI tools roundup, but this now allows you to use a first and last frame image. So this is really cool. Let's get started in my account here and click into Runway Gen 3 Alpha. Now, you might have seen last week, if you didn't watch it, go and watch that video where I covered Flux. It's the brilliant new AI image generator from the original people from Stable Diffusion that's making waves on the internet. Many creators this week have said that potentially it's better than Midjourney. So I'm going to go ahead and create a first frame inside Flux Pro. And for this, I'll just use a simple prompt. I want to create a small floating island drifting through the clouds with a waterfall cascading off the edge into the sky and mystical plants growing along its surface. Let's see what Flux One Pro comes up with. Okay, that's an incredible piece of work. I'm going to download it. And now we can move over to Runway Gen 3 Alpha, drag and drop that image from Flux. Now I have the option to describe my shot or just leave it to do whatever it thinks is appropriate. So let's generate with this image. Now, while this is generating, you'll see that you have the ability to choose 10 seconds or 5 second duration video. You can also open up the settings here, change the seed, remove the watermark and things like that. And of course, you can choose whether it's going to be the first frame or the last frame. So in this case, it will start with this image as my first frame and then morph and do whatever it's going to do with it. And I've got to say, it's very simple, but it follows the laws of physics exactly, with the water flowing and running and most of the island staying absolutely static. So the attention to detail here with the real physical world is incredible. So I'm going to use this image of me as the first frame in the next video and say man changes into a complete robot as the prompt. And let's generate a 5 second clip. Okay, I've got my man's face slowly turning into a robot. I gotta say, this is pretty crazy stuff. Now, I've been playing around with generations in Flux, and I've got something that I quite like here. Ancient circle of stones in the middle of the night. Let's grab this. And for the prompt here, we'll go lightning and heavy rain. And we'll generate a 10-second clip. While that's generating, I'm going to use it also as the first frame, and I'm going to say night transforms into a sunny day, and click generate again. Now, using this technique, once the generations are complete, I should be able to stitch both the first and last frame clips together seamlessly to create a 20-second clip, which is pretty incredible. One feature that I really hope that Runway will introduce in the future, similar to Luma Labs, is the ability to have a first and a last frame in the same generation, so you can generate something that morphs from one thing into another thing. And as you'll see, when I stick both of these clips together, we start off with something very stormy and very wet and middle of the night that quickly transforms into our first and last frame image and then flows on to be the sunshine and beautiful, hopeful video that you see at the end. 20 seconds generated entirely with one image and a couple of text prompts inside Runway Gen 3 Alpha. The ability to add these first and last frame images now is absolutely incredible. And I hope they follow suit with Luma Labs, you can have first and last frame in the same generation, so you can morph one thing to another thing with ease. Finally, we've heard rumors of strawberries from everywhere, not least of which OpenAI and Sam Altman on X, saying he loves summer in the garden, referencing strawberries. There's been a lot of strawberry talk this week in the AI space, and Limsys chatbot Arena has a new model available, apparently. We'll start by asking it, who are you? And this says it's an AI assistant developed by Column AI. Now, funnily enough, I know that if it describes itself as Column AI, that is indeed Sus Column R, which is supposedly rumored to be the new strawberry model from OpenAI. Let's ask it a really difficult reasoning question to see how far on the way to AGI we really are. Let's ask, how would you go about making all humans on the planet happy and send that to our new model? Okay, and here we have a fine detailed answer, ensuring the basic needs are met, free education for all, job opportunities. Most interestingly, it's asking for a universal basic income. We can go on with this, but if I say A is better, we do find out it is the new Sus Column R. Now, we don't know this, but many people online presently are rumoring this to be the new strawberry, formerly known as Q-Star model from OpenAI. Now, while I think this is fascinating and interesting, and I really hope there is a new model dropped soon from OpenAI. In fact, when this video is out, the model may be dropped. I don't know that. But something I found really interesting in news from OpenAI that I don't think has been made a big deal of this week is the fact that they've now made available their text-to-speech voices in the API playground for anyone to play with. Let me show you. So if you go to the link I'll provide down below, you can try text-to-speech voices from OpenAI that were previously never available inside the playground. You had to use the command line, and it was pretty tricky unless you knew what you were doing. But now, in the text-to-speech playground, I can choose a voice. They've got 6 different voices. We'll stick with Alloy. You can choose whether it's TTS1 or the HD model. You can choose the speed, and you can also choose the format of file you'll get and type a quick script as well to try it out. So there we go. Just a quick script about Creator Magic. Let's click Generate.
This is Creator Magic. Thanks for watching, and remember to subscribe.
Now, I think the voices that OpenAI produce are really realistic. Up until now, you have not been able to do this in the playground. I can go ahead and download that as an MP3 file if I wish to use in my projects. And I can go on and maybe type something different. This time, let's go for Echo. We'll go for the text-to-speech HD model, and we'll maybe speed it up twice speed and generate.
All the links to all the AI tools will be down below in the description.
Okay, that was a bit fast. Let's make it one speed.
All the links to all the AI tools will be down below in the description.
And I can even change the voice really quickly to Nova and do it again.
All the links to all the AI tools will be down below in the description.
Okay, nice. Pauses, breaths, realistic human speech. It's really cool stuff. Go and try Text-to-Speech Playground right now using the link down below. And something I would highlight to you in the text-to-speech documents from OpenAI, do I own the outputted audio files? Yes! Like with all outputs from our API, the person who created them owns the output. You're still required to inform the end users they're hearing audio generated by AI, not a real person. But that means you can essentially use these realistic voices from OpenAI in your projects without the need to worry about copyright, as long as you're informing the end user that it's an AI-generated voice. Pretty cool. And remember, I do these roundups weekly, so make sure you subscribe to never miss another video. There's also a link down below to my weekly email newsletter, so you get all the AI tools in your inbox. And there is a playlist showing on your screen right now if you want to go down the rabbit hole and see AI tools that I've covered in previous weeks on this channel.